Hello everybody, welcome back to another video. Today we're doing another Kiss album review. This is Destroyer now, and yeah, let's just get straight into it. Now, probably everyone's, well, mostly everyone's number 10, Great Expectations. I've never liked this song, it's not really that good. I give it a 3 out of 10. I didn't really write notes for any of these songs, but I'll try my best and come up with some on the spot. The riff is okay. That's about it. 3 out of 10. I'm gonna get a lot of shit for putting this 9th. Wait, no. 8th, because it's 9 songs. Number 8. Oh, thanks for ruining it. Oh, go away, lads. Beth. Now, I put 4 out of 10 on this one, but I'm changing that. It's 7 out of 10. Actually, it's 6. It's not the greatest. I don't mind it. That's pretty much my way of putting it. It's simple, and that's just how it is. Just simple, in my opinion. Don't hate it, though. But it's, like, in the middle. But yeah, and if that's number 6, then this album is great. Okay, I've got 2 at 7.5. I'm gonna say this is number 7. Number 7, Flaming Youth. It's a decent song, 7.5 out of 10. The solo, I think, is like, this is a solid song. I wouldn't really listen to it much often, which is why it's only 7.5. And same with this one. This song is a pretty decent one too. I'll give it the same rating. It's a bit better than Flaming Youth. I think it's put together well, and they've performed this more live, which live it sounds really good, but it sounds really good on the album too. I just prefer live versions. But yeah, that's probably just me. You probably just prefer the studio one. But yeah, they sometimes open the show with this one, and I understand why. It's a good track. But yeah, 8.5. Oh wait, sorry. That's my rating. Yeah, number, is it 5? I think it's number 5. Oh, I forgot, it doesn't have a, it's the stupid intro, like, the start. Detroit Rock City. It's really good. When I saw them live, about a month or two ago, in June, this was a good song to open the show. Like, I mean, I know they performed it really slow, and Paul's voice kind of ruins it. But overall, just, like, that's how, like, even though they're performing it live now and it doesn't sound the best, that shows how good the song is. Like, the opening it, like, I'm pretty sure it's the most played open song to, that doesn't really make sense. It's like the most common song that they start the show with, like, ever. I think, like, this is the best to probably start it off. I'd say there's, like, a few other good songs to start off the show, but yeah, this is a really good song. The solo is good. The chorus is good. In my opinion, it's a bit too long, but, you know, that's just my opinion. That's the only problem about this song. And it's a decent song. Number 4.
Are you close? Oh,
fuck off. Fuck off! Do You Love Me? They also played this when I went to the concert. It's a pretty good song to play it. They played it second last, I think, just before Rock and Roll Night. It's pretty good. I love this song. The solo is good. I like the bridge. The chorus is really good. Yeah, that's all I have to say. It's a really good song. Number 3.
Oh,
9 out of 10. Yeah, it's a really catchy song. I love the chorus especially. The bridge is really good, the solo's good. This is just an all-on good song. Like, there's nothing bad about this song. Like, the intro isn't the catchiest, but the solo is good. Why is this the most recent? The chorus, that's why. But yeah, this is just a good song. I do like this song a lot. Yeah, there's nothing wrong about it. In second place.
Okay.
God of Thunder in second place. It's 9.5 out of 10. This is a really good song. Like, there's nothing wrong about it. Just doesn't quite make it to that 10 spot. I don't think I've ever had a 10, like a number 10 before on a review. But yeah, this is a good song though. I really do like it. Like, especially like when they performed it in 1990 and Creatures of the Night tour. Like, that's a really good version of it. I do like God of Thunder a lot. It's a solid track. Nothing wrong about it, the solo was good. Yeah, in first place. Shout It Out Loud, 9.5 out of 10 again. This is a better song than God of Thunder in my opinion. Like, it has more energy and it's a bit faster paced, which is what I like. It's a bit short, which I complain about songs being too long, but I wish this was a little bit longer. Doesn't quite make it 3 minutes, but either way, it's still a good song. Just wish it was a bit longer. Probably that's why it's not a 10, maybe. But yeah, I do like the song, especially live. They played this live when I saw them. They played a lot of songs off this when I was live. They played Detroit Rock City, God of Thunder, Shout Out Loud, Beth, Do You Love Me. Played 5 songs off this album, wow. It just shows how good this album is and how this is the number one, top rated album. But anyways, it's not for me, I don't think. But anyways, that's this review over. This is a pretty good one. There's only one meh and one okay. But then other than that, it's a really good album. I'd say this is really good. Will it be my top 5? It probably will actually, if I think about it. I always complain this album's overrated. I don't think it's overrated now. But anyways, thanks all for watching, and I'll see you in the next episode for Rock and Roll Over. Bye.